Good afternoon, welcome to Daily Currency Update from the Currency Desk. Today in the morning session, as we saw the Indian rupee open slightly stronger against the US dollar, there was eventually a stalemate which formed in the markets as we had a weak opening for the domestic equity markets and we saw the pre-opening Sensex and Nifty fall down by around more than 1%. Again, contrary to this, we had the overnight data for the US front. The jobs data came in better than expected, so as compared to this, the expectations of quantitative easing being reduced were erased from the markets. Also, we had the IIP data and the CPI data which came in positive and better than expectations. So based on these factors, we saw the Indian rupee narrow down in a very small range against the US dollar. But yes, later in the day, as we see the European data coming out in the markets, due to the relative weakness in the European markets, we could see the US dollar rally against the Indian rupee. At current levels, we recommend a buy in the US dollar against the Indian rupee with a stop loss of 54.20 and a target of 55.20. Coming to Europe, we saw the euro trade strong against most of the global peers, all the major currency exchanges in the globe. This was mainly because of the strong quantitative easing done by the Bank of Japan alongside the US Federal Reserve. So we are seeing a lot of free fund flow into the European economy, wherein the actual bond yields are pretty higher as compared to other economies across the globe. Due to this, we saw the euro rally against the US dollar. Currently it had crossed above 1.31 levels, but later on as the day progressed and we had the German data coming out in the market, the German CPI fell and was lower than expectations. Due to this CPI data, we are seeing the hopes that the economy would not perform that well, or another signal of recession in the German economy. And because of this very same reason, we saw the euro fall below 1.31 levels against the US dollar. Similar movement was seen against the Indian rupee as well. At current levels, we recommend a sell in the euro with a target of 70 against the Indian rupee. Coming to pound, we saw the pound rally because of two major reasons. One was because of the recent strong economic data, out of which one of them was UK industrial production data, which beat market expectations and came in much better than expected. So it helped calm the traders' nerves as regards to another triple dip recession in the UK economy. Another reason for the rally in the pound was the fact that due to the recent sell-off in the euro, there is a lot of gain for the pound in value against the euro. So due to this carry trade, we are seeing a relative gain in the value of pound, which is seeing an inflow of all the outflows that have been done in the other countries in the eurozone. If we have the US retail sales data out to be due today evening coming in lower than expected, then again we could see the pound rally against the US dollar. So the near term US dollar weakness is also expected to support the current pound rally, and based on this we recommend a hold long in the pound against the Indian rupee with a stop loss of 83.29 and a near term target of 84.50. Coming to Japanese yen, Japanese yen had a strong weaker opening against the Indian rupee, but yes, it was trading strong against the US dollar. In the morning session, we had the tertiary goods production data coming out in the markets, which was better than expected. Based on this data, we saw the Japanese yen rally. Yes, another thing that impacted the rally of the Japanese yen was a statement from the BOJ governor. He has indicated that they would consider a revision of the current inflation target from 2% to 1.5%. This lowering of inflation target means that we could see the Japanese yen rally in the near term. So based on this, we recommend a buy at current levels with a target of 63.30 in the near term against the Indian rupee. Thank you.